Michael Church, Crawl Space Ninja. Today we got a great topic. We're gonna talk about efflorescence. What is efflorescence? Is it white mold? Is it dangerous? And how to get rid of it? Stay tuned. If you're new to Crawl Space Ninja, we talk about everything related to crawl space waterproofing, encapsulation, indoor air quality. We hope you'll subscribe to our channel, ring that notifications bell, follow us on Facebook if you're a DIYer. Make sure you check out our diy.crawlspaceninja.com. If you're looking for a franchise opportunity, we also have a link to that below as well. So a few years ago, I did a video about efflorescence. A lot of people think that efflorescence is mold, and I just want to tell you, it is not mold. So let's see exactly what efflorescence is. Efflorescence is a crystalline deposit of salts that can form when water is present in or on brick, concrete, stone, stucco, or other building products. It has a white or grayish tint and consists of salt deposits that remain on the surface after the water evaporates. So that right there ought to tell you that efflorescence is not mold. Now, I do want to make a distinction that if you see those white salt deposits on a non-painted block wall in your crawl space or concrete wall in your crawl space, that is probably just efflorescence. But if you have painted that wall and you see bubbling of the paint, the efflorescence could be behind it, but the paint can become a mold food source. So the paint itself could have mold on it while efflorescence is behind it. So I don't want you to be confused in that. So you could still have mold on that block wall if the wall is painted, but if it's not painted, there's a good chance it's only those salt deposits. So to answer that question even more, is efflorescence mold? Mold is a fungus. Efflorescence is moisture that evaporates and leaves behind salt deposit. Mold is a type of fungus that consists of small organisms found almost everywhere. According to WebMD, they can be black, white, orange, green, or purple. And as I mentioned before, efflorescence is a salt deposit that is typically yellow, white, or brown. But what we mostly see is a white deposit in our part of the country. But I think it can turn colors based on if you've got mud or different things like that coming through the foundation wall as well. So indirectly, efflorescence can create a mold problem. And what I mean by that is that the efflorescence is a sign or something telling you that there's a water intrusion issue coming through that block, concrete, brick, stone wall that you have in your house, right? So if that humidity or that water's coming through that foundation wall, it typically becomes humidity. Humidity above 60% is dangerous in the sense that it can create a mold problem. So that high humidity builds up, gets absorbed in the insulation in the subfloor itself, or the joists, and then those joists then can grow mold. So efflorescence itself isn't mold, but it can create an environment that is good for mold to grow in. So how do you get rid of efflorescence? Well, typically in a crawl space or an unfinished basement, you're not really gonna do a whole lot to get rid of it, because most of the time you're gonna have, like I mentioned, a foundation wall that's got moisture coming through on a continual basis. So the efflorescence is gonna be constantly a problem that you're gonna have to deal with. So it's kind of like whenever you go out and you pressure wash your sidewalk, for example, that gets rid of the dirt. Well, next year you're gonna have to do it again. Well, you don't wanna go down in your basement, your unfinished basement or your crawl space and pressure wash the efflorescence off, because you're adding moisture to that area, which can become a mold problem in the future. So what we do is we put in the interior waterproofing system, the sump pump, all that. So that way, as the water comes through the foundation wall, we're directing it, getting it out of the crawl space, putting the vapor barrier over that block wall, which has the efflorescence on it, and then controlling humidity. And that for us in a crawl space or an unfinished basement is the best way to handle that. But if you're dealing with efflorescence on the outside, then here are some recommendations. So like in my neighborhood, a lot of the mailboxes are made of brick, and you can see the efflorescence coming through the brick, or if your home is brick, you probably have some evidence of efflorescence on that. So according to prosico.com, and I'll put a link to that down below, the best way to remove efflorescence involves stiff brushes, water, and chemicals. And basically you're gonna use a combination of all those things to scrub off that efflorescence, but don't think it's permanent, because if there's those salt deposits still in that brick, as that moisture returns, it's gonna draw those salt deposits out And you're probably gonna have to do that every 1 to 2 years. So as I mentioned, I'll put a link to their website down below so you can address that outside efflorescence if you have that at your home. So is efflorescence harmful to your health? Well, no, it's a salt deposit. Now, as I mentioned before, it can create or be the evidence of a moisture problem, which creates an indoor air quality problem. And for those of you that are new to our channel, that is really our main focus, is indoor air quality. And keep in mind, high humidity without mold can still cause bacterias, fungi, and virus and dust mites to grow out of control as well. So efflorescence can add to that humidity. Even though you may not have mold in the crawl space, you could have other things that thrive in high humid environments that can also affect your indoor air qualities. But efflorescence itself is not dangerous, unless of course you try to put it on your food, because it is a salt deposit, which we don't recommend you do that. So to sum it up, what I recommend you do, if you see that you have efflorescence in your basement, your unfinished basement, or your crawl space, make sure you properly waterproof, control humidity, all that sort of stuff. Make sure that you're properly insulating like we do here at Crawl Space Ninja, and it shouldn't be an issue moving forward. Don't paint those block walls, don't paint those foundation walls, and of course address efflorescence on the outside of your house if it becomes an eyesore for you to see every day. And I'm Michael Church, Crawl Space Ninja. We hope you make it a happy and blessed day. And we'll see you later.